Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. As we head towards kickoff, two quarterbacks will be on the field today trying to push their team to victory. It's Jared Goff's Rams going up against Marcus Mariota's Titans. With that, let's welcome in our fine broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, thank you, Larry. We are across the Cumberland River from downtown Nashville at Nissan Stadium in Tennessee. The whole of downtown Nashville likely still reverberating with the sounds of the Titans taking the field a moment ago. They're ready for football as their Titans are set to match up with the Los Angeles Rams. Hi again, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. And you know, now more than ever, it's a passing league. We know that. And as Larry hit onto the open, we've got a couple of great passers squaring off here this afternoon.
And usually the discussion centers in on how they're going to compete against the opposite defense. But you and I had a nice little chat with one of these guys in this game. And they did say, look, I'm always competing against the opposite quarterback. If I play better than he does, I think my team has an advantage.
Makes the handshake afterwards a little sweeter, too. A lot has changed since these two met in Super Bowl 34, and off we go between the Rams and Titans. Here's Eric Weems now on the return. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Tennessee Titans jogging onto the field. They'll be led by their quarterback, Marcus Mariota. Now, this is a group, Charles, and the Titans. They were rolling for a while. Winners of 6-7 in the middle of the season. And then they had close losses at Arizona and San Fran. Kind of put a wrench in what they were hoping to do down the stretch. But focus on Mariota. Hasn't been the year that he had hoped for.
No, not at all. Because I think most of us expect him to take the big jump here in year three as a starter in the NFL. He's had some injuries. This taking away his mobility. He's had some leg injuries, and that's hurt him a little bit. But you just mentioned close losses to Arizona and San Francisco. Teams that are going to the playoffs should find ways to beat those two teams. Right, this is that type of a year. And Marcus Mariota said it himself. He's not played his best football. In fact, got frustrated and had a rough media encounter before mom called and said, you need to apologize. I did not raise you to be rude with the media. And that's exactly what he did.
And the big boys up front in the trenches. What do you think of the O-line, Charles?
I love them because this is a group that's so cohesive. They know what the man next to them is going to do at all times. And they operate as a terrific unit.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Now some movement before the snap. And we'll hear from our referee for the first time this afternoon. So that'll back him up five.
Still second down.
With second down run for Murray. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Nothing there, no gain, and now they're looking at a third and 15. The defense here for the Rams.
Let's take a look at Michael Brocker's defensive tackle. This is a young man who understands leverage. Rarely do I see him bowled over by an offensive lineman. Usually he's the one who's underneath them, moving them, creating space, and getting upfield to make tackles.
And I don't think this is the script they had in mind for their opening drive. This is third and long. Working out of the gun, Mariota. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
Trust me, Brandon, I'm not about to try and take your job. I can't do what you do. But that wasn't just three and out. That felt like three and backwards.
That's exactly what it was. You can have my job whenever you want it. The drive that you're looking for, though, probably going forward, bad start to the ball game.
Yeah, not the way to get things going.
In his 10th year, here's Brett Kern to punt this one. He'll kick it away after a three and out on the opening drive of the game. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And that hits at the six and carries into the end zone for a touchback. The Rams taking the field. Jared Goff, their quarterback, helping lead them to double-digit wins this season. And after last year, Charles, there were whispers, well, maybe Jared Goff is a bust. Well, 2017 says that Jared Goff is not a bust, and the Rams, they certainly are not a bust.
When are we going to learn that with draft picks, you really need three full seasons before you make the full assessment?
That's kind of where your gauge is.
To me, it's three full seasons in the NFL before I say one way or the other and start to get definitive about it. Change in coaching staff, change in coaching for him, better personnel around him, starting with the offensive line, receivers. Todd Gurley back in form as a runner, and Jared Goff has raised his game. What's that new expression they're using around Los Angeles now? Let's go golfing. That's what I keep hearing.
And he's going to lose yardage here, back to his own 18. It'll wind up being a loss of two, and that'll make it second and 12.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they know how to finish plays, too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
And they're behind the sticks here a bit now, dealing with a second and 12. Out of the gun, gone. He's going to float this one deep right side. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete. We introduce you to these starters now, and Tavon Austin, a man who really doesn't need any introduction anymore in this league.
He did it all when he's at the University of West Virginia. Played wide receiver, slot, returned kicks, even lined up a tailback and ran for over 300 yards. All of those talents will be on display in this game. A nickel set shown by the Titans on third down.
Thinking pass. A shotgun snap for Goff. And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up fourth down.
And that's a great opening series defensively. You force what should be a three and out on your opening possession.
And great coverage there on third down to force the incompletion to set up fourth. It's Johnny Hecker now, an All-Pro three of the last 4 years, on to punt, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. With it is Jackson. The quick feet by Jackson. You call that an even 50 yards on the punt, with seven on the return. And it'll be Titan football. Here's the Titan offense now as they make their way back onto the field. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went three and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guys a little bit jumpy.
You do.
Oh, you understand the same way. It's just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went
and
three and out.
And now they have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go three and out. I went three and out on that first drive. I'll try to do better here. Here's Murray now as they run it to start the drive. Looking for an opening, not much there. He'll get it to the 39. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out of it. Because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Again, it's Murray. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. That's a first down pickup for Tennessee on a gain of 10. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only are they controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to the linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. They go play action here on first down. And this one caught by Delanie Walker. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 23 yards on the play.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I think you get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
Now the offense lining up first and 10. From the pistol, they run it with Murray. Looking to find a lane, but he can't, reined in at the line of scrimmage. And Murray's still down. Maybe shaking up that go-around. Let's hope he's all right. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. First carry for Derrick Henry. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He's able to rattle off 6 on the carry, and that'll get him to 3rd and 4.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Mariota from the gun on 3rd down. He's going to be sacked back at the 23-yard line. Michael Brockers able to get in there and drop him behind the line. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
Here's Ryan Succop for the Titan field goal. This a 40-yard attempt from the left hash. And Succop will put this one right through. And the Titans hit the scoreboard first. It's 3-0. So it's a 7-play drive, but it stalls out in the end.
Let's credit the defensive front 7. They were a little leaky at the start of the drive, but they stiffened toward the end.
Succop now set to kick it off following the made field goal. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Start out on the ground with Gurley, and he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. Speaking of Todd Gurley, Charles, you and I had a lengthy discussion in the offseason about his sophomore slump, but he has picked it back up this year, and maybe nothing more indicative of that than that Week 15 performance.
Fantastic. In Seattle, in the game one against Seattle in 2017, he ran for 43 total yards. In this one, he ran for 152. Actually caught a pass for a touchdown as well, so he had 4 total touchdowns. He looks the part. And when we're starting to talk about MVPs, his name doesn't get enough mention. It should, because Todd Gurley's having a monster year, over 1,000 yards rushing, 11 games now where he's had over 100 yards from scrimmage in 2017. You say MVP, you can talk about Tom Brady, Carson Wentz, Russell Wilson. You need to bring Todd Gurley's name into the discussion.
Now on second down, this is Gurley. He takes this from the 30 to the 34.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
They'll try and pick up the first with Gurley. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. They only get 2 there, but on third and 1, that's all they needed to keep the drive going.
I like this focus there because he wasn't thinking about breaking that one big. All he thought about was, I need 1. Let's go get that. Ended up picking up 2.
Down, it's Gurley, and very little room to maneuver. He'll get this down to about the 39. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. They'll try the air now with Goff. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
The one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept him on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Goff. And he comes back with 1 complete. And he'll be knocked down sideways. Goff finding fellow second-year man Higbee for a Rams first down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
First down, gone. And he's got his man on the out route. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
But when you hit him on the move like that, and he's able to get into open field with a full head of steam, oh boy, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down.
All right.
has yardage, brought down at the 32. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Partner, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen, we have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle. To go here in the first half. Back to Tennessee after this. Don't forget, coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Larry Ridley. Larry will have the highlights of this first half, but he won't have touchdowns because we haven't had any to this point.
But there's still time, though, partner.
Second down. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. Sammy Watkins, the intended target, and it'll bring up third down.
They always say that real estate is about location. Well, guess what? When it's a slant route, the quick ones, timing, timing, timing. Got to be able to lead your man with the football.
And the timing off right there, threw it behind him. The Rams on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third down and 12. Goff now to throw, and that is incomplete. Well, not to get too overcritical there, because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right, that pass will go from incomplete to complete.
So on fourth down, Sean McVay going to send out the field goal unit. This is a 49-yard attempt, right hash. And that is no good. And this score will stay right where it is.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
The Titans offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yeah, run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it? Touchdowns.
First down, Mariota. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
6 yards here to go for the offense on second down. From the gun, Mariota. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. He was looking for DeMarco Murray out of the backfield, and it's third down.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
On third down, Mariota. And he locates Walker, complete. And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45. A Titan first down, Mariota to Walker.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Rush number 29.
Mariota on first down. And he'll get it down here to the 43. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and it'll make it second down. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout, as he'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. Let's see what the offense comes with here. Second and 8. From the shotgun, it's Mariota. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
The Titans on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Throwing is Mariota. To Decker over the middle. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to 4th down. So out comes a field goal team now for the second time here today. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And this kick is not going to be close. It's well short, well right to boot. And this score will stay right where it is.
And this is one of the risks you run when you attempt a long field goal. If you miss, the defense takes over the spot of the placement. So now they've got a chance to get one more drive in before halftime.
Down throw, gone. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be 2nd down.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet, flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
Second and 10, Goff. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. And welcome back. The offensive unit, they took the timeout. And now they get set to line up as we resume action. The Rams on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3. The final shot before break here. Goff. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. So we are at halftime here on Christmas Eve, as we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon. Thanks, Charles. And welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. Both the Titans and the Rams are not doing much on the ground, and it's easy to see why that would play into this low-scoring game. We'll have to see if either team gets it going on the ground in the second half. All right, let's roll those highlights. Now 1st and 10, Mariota's gonna find his mark. and he won't be brought down until he makes it to the 28-yard line. Titans would go on to kick a field goal. Rams have the football midway through the second. Everett's wide open, able to make the grab, and he'll end up at the 30-yard line before being tackled. Rams would later attempt a field goal that would miss the mark. Titans now late in the second. Walker's got nobody around him on the catch, and he'll end up at the 45-yard line before being tackled. Score stays the same, though, as they miss the field goal. So that'll wrap it up for us here at the EA Sports Studio. We'll head back now to Nashville for the start of the second half.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This will be fielded at the six. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Here's the Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Play fake here on first down. Open man right side is Kupp, complete. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. Give him a couple on the catch at second and eight. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. On second down, here's Goff. Over the middle, that's hauled in by Kupp. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't they?
Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
From the gun on third down, Goff. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down. Another drive comes and goes, still nothing on the scoreboard.
Yeah, and when the second half comes, you know, it's real easy to get discouraged and wonder if you're ever going to get things started. You just got to fight through it. Got to keep pounding away.
Here's Johnny Hecker now on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. The Titans offense gears up for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Now how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. They begin the drive with a run by Murray. And he is going to lose yardage here. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. To say they've kept him under wraps running the football, that's an understatement. He's been completely neutralized.
Yeah, they've essentially taken him out of the game, haven't they? And you know all the teams say, we're not going to let him beat us. Well, that's exactly what's happened here. They've lived up to that.
Second down and a little ways to go here. Second and 13. They go with Murray again. And he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. Just a yard there, so it brings up a tough third and 12.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
The Titans on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is third down and 12. To throw is Mariota. And this is caught, but I don't think he stayed in bounds. No, he didn't. It's incomplete. The throw took him past the boundary, and it's fourth. A third down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out, trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And that's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And the Rams will go on offense here with a first and 10. And the Rams now coming out on the field. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
Time to establish the run game here. Gurley. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. A gain of 3, second down.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutralized. Second down following the run. From the gun, here's Goff. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Turns and gives to Gurley. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one?
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here. Again, they run with Gurley. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Nashville. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point, just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Sylvester Williams, never giving up. He's able to keep working and get him for a loss of 12.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and they can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there.
To throw on second down is gone. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
The Rams on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and 14. Now Goff. And they'll set up the screen to Gurley. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. And a screen only good for 3 that time, and it'll bring up a fourth down.
They dialed up the screen pass on third down, and for a second it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a first down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
Here's Johnny Hecker now, as he's on to punt for L.A. This one angles out of bounds at a good spot in the coffin corner. And they're going to mark this out of the 5-yard line. The Titans offense now, they get ready to do battle again here. They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow of your own goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again. So it's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up 5 or 6 first downs and make sure you move the ball into their territory.
Very tough spot here for the offense to start. First down, Murray, and he's going to be run over, hit hard, as he'll be marked down right at the line of scrimmage. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all 3 still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning. They run with Murray, and a nice pickup as this one gets him to the 10-yard line. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll set up a third down.
And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here, partner. And there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here if they have any hopes of winning this game.
Pastor, you said big third down. I'd put the word big in capital letters here. Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Mariota. And this is going to be incomplete. Here's Brett Kern now, as he's on to punt for Tennessee. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. This is brought in at the 21. A big hitter that time in the punt game. 66 yards on the boot. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. And the Rams getting set to go now. And, you know, their previous possession, they were able to move the football, but still wound up punting in the end.
You know, in 2016, Carolina had a 20-play drive that lasted over 10 minutes. And remember how it ended?
In a punt.
Yeah, I mean, how does that happen? You just don't see that happen every day.
This one maybe not quite that bad, but still, you'd like to have a chance for points if you hold the football that long.
Agreed.
First down, it's gone. And the open receiver, it's Robert Woods. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Goff. Over the middle, it's complete. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. They'll look to throw. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well. He's back to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Wesley Woodyard. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. Thought they had something going there to break that goose egg here in the second half, but to no avail.
Hope was alive until that interception. What a terrific play, taking the ball away after it looked like they were starting a drive.
And now that shutout still standing, you know that's something those defensive guys hold a lot of pride on, too.
No doubt about it. They're excited about where they are in this game.
And the Titans getting set to go. They have the 3-point lead. Defense did their job. Now, late game. Although it looks good, you know the coaches, they haven't counted this as a victory yet.
I agree with you totally. Big applause for the defense, but no one has taken their headset off on the sidelines. They don't believe this game is over. The offense has to close this one out by taking care of the football.
And they'll try to close it out now. They'll run it left side with Murray. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. And now the Rams are going to halt things as they want a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. It's already second and 12. The defense hoping to push him back more. Tenth carry of the game now, Murray. And he's across the 40, three extra yards to the 43. Yeah, the Rams are going to go ahead and take another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So a defensive timeout, chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. The Titans on third down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. This is third and 7. Mariota gives to Henry, and he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. Here's Brett Kern now. He's been terrific so far. This is going to be ruled out, I think, just inside the 20. Yes, it will. Side judge calls it at the 19-yard line. Jared Goff and the Rams headed back onto the field. Certainly they want to win this game, but down 3, they know what they need to do. Get in field goal range, at least have a chance to tie.
And if you approach it the right way, you almost have a safety net. Knowing just a field goal gets it done, you don't press for the touchdown. But you take it if the opportunity comes, if the opening's there. Someone slips in the secondary and you get a big play. But otherwise, get the 3, put that on the board, and try to extend the game.
They'll be trying to muster 3. Of course, they'd love the score to win it. Back to throw. Wide open receiver complete. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Back to throw. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. So 2nd and 10 here. He'll look to throw. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right? Whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case the feet, did a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. So now third and 10. A big play to start the drive, but nothing since. Now it's gone. And this one is incomplete.
So another big shot dodged there defensively. Now they're just one more incompletion away from salting away this victory. And I know this feeling. They're almost giddy, but they have to stay focused and locked in. They can make one big mistake and throw it all away.
One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And got a man. It's Woods. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. And they'll spike it here at 27 seconds. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. Huge play at this point in the game. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. And he'll get up and spike it with 11 seconds remaining. They converted once earlier in this drive, but they'll roll the dice here again on fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that'll be just about all she wrote for this one. Well, their first fourth down attempt earlier was successful. This one backfires for a turnover on downs.
I like their aggressiveness. I like what they're doing. They got it the first time they went for it. Why not a second time? I don't think they'll be daunted from attempting it again. If you're on the defensive side of the ball, though, any fourth down stop is a big momentum play.
Mariota with a knee to the ground, and that should be it. The storyline in this one, Charles, no doubt the number zero, zilch, nada. A shutout so hard to do in the NFL.
It really is. What an accomplishment, because you feel that not just on the defensive side, but as a full team. There's a lot of pride that goes into shutting out an opponent. And how about that zero on the scoreboard for them? Going along with those zeros in the time column, too.
So that's a wrap. For Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The Titans are winners here as we say so long.